Manchester, let's get this party started! Coming to the ring first, the Rickster, Ricky Burns!
Wonderful to hear the dulcet tones of the legendary Michael Buffer to really set the scene for a crackling match of former world champions. Great stories, great guys, the pair of them, great atmosphere. Here we go. To Scotland's first ever three-way king, Ricky Burns, who at one stage was struggling to even win a British belt. It's been an amazing 16-year story, which has seen Ricky go from a stockist at a local sports shop in Cambridge to a stellar boxing career, courtesy of talent, persistence, attitude, and Scottish grit. What's left after that difficult defeat to Julius Ndongo at 34? I tell you what, Cole, he looked fabulous on the scales.
He did look fabulous on the scales, and you know, we're hearing he's in the best shape of his life. At 34, I'm not sure how much I believe that, but I know he's worked hard, and we know the experience he brings into this ring. Many times he's been written off, and many times he's risen again to world honours. Is this the best of the last of Burns? We'll wait and see.
And now, making his entrance to the ring, Anthony Million Dollar!
Advantage, both were excellent on the scales, although particularly Burns, but he is coming back down to lightweight. Could that be an issue? Look at that. 373 to 251 rounds. Enormous experience. Crawler, the marginal favourite. But money has come on Burns, who was 2-1 against, now 15-8. The draw at 22-1. Will it be a pick-up? We cannot wait for this.
I think it will be tight. I really do. My pick's Crawler, but don't be surprised if Burns seizes through to the 12th round and causes an upset, because a Crawler loss, the general consensus is that would be the upset.
Ladies and gentlemen, from Manchester Arena, Eddie Hearn for Matchroom Boxing proudly presents the main event of the evening. 12 rounds of boxing in the lightweight division. And it's all sponsored by William Hill, StubHub, Mastered Fit, and JD Sports. This contest sanctioned by the British Boxing Board of Control. Steward in charge, Alistair Hayes. Timekeeper at the bell, Barry Pender. The three judges scoring, Steve Gray, Michael Alexander, and Victor Laughlin. And when the bell rings, your referee in charge of the action, Terry O'Connor. And now, for the thousands in attendance and the millions watching around the world, ladies and gentlemen, from Manchester, let's get ready. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner, wearing black trimmed with yellow, officially weighing in at 9 stone, 8 pounds, 9 ounces. His professional record, 31 victories, including 13 wins by knockout, 6 defeats and 1 draw. He's the former British and Commonwealth champion, former WBO Intercontinental champion, and former lightweight champion of the world. The fighting pride of Manchester, Anthony Million Dollar Crawler. And his opponent across the ring, fighting out of the red corner, wearing white, red, and blue, officially weighing in at 9 stone, 8 pounds, 5 ounces. As a professional, 41 victories, including 14 wins by knockout, 6 defeats, 1 draw. A 3-time, 3-division world champion from Coatbridge, Scotland, the former super featherweight, former lightweight, former super lightweight champion of the world, the Rickster.
Electric. You'd think many world titles were on the line. It is one of the compelling domestic crossroad clashes as the former world lightweight champion Anthony Crawler and the three-weight winner Ricky Burns collide to see who has more in store, more left in the locker. 8 years after they sparred, talk of the meeting for years. Finally, we have it. It's a terrific tussle, and there's a real bite in the air here.
There is. The fans here strongly for Crawler. Burns got his favourite fans, though. They're making some noise for Ricky Burns, and he deserves that. He deserves the respect because he's been a great champion. We've said it a few times, three-weight world champion, Scotland's only, and is he at the end of his career? Has he got anything left? I think he has. He's trained well. He's only 34. Crawler, 30 years old, the younger man, but this is such an evenly matched fight.
Tactics so crucial. Will Burns be able to get behind his penetrating jab that controls the ring so well like that? Will Crawler be able to nip in and out? He's often a slow starter, Crawler.
but tries to work the body early. Defence crucial. These two know their way around the ring so well, and they have enormous respect for each other.
The depth, though, each fighter is more than capable. I think it's Crawler's job to try and get close, and Ricky Burns' job to just try and keep that jab going and keep it at range as long as he can. Crawler's not going to rush in and do anything silly. He's well-schooled at world level, but the sooner he can get close to Burns, my feeling is the sooner he'll start to have more success.
Both have been called overachievers. Well, how they have overachieved. Wonderful accolades, especially for Ricky Burns at three different weights. Who will have the edge in speed? Burns has ground himself back down to 9 stone 9. Hasn't seen that on the scales for several years. Crawler more natural at this weight, younger by 4 years. Just out of range there with his own jab.
Hard to land that jab when you're slightly behind on the reach. You just bring them feet in under your punches, and you seem to find home usually with them punches. Trying the left hook there. Both men staying off each other, standing off, but you know, eager. You can see them just waiting to let go of the punches and the counter punches. They both want to work, both want to establish themselves early on.
There's that long spearing jab of Burns. Crawler light on his feet. But he has got the advantage in that department, Burns, and a nice right hand. He looks quick, and a slight marking on the bridge of the nose for Crawler. Has Burns had the slightly sharper start here?
He's found home a couple of times with that long jab. But Burns has had his successes, and he's hooking a bit more, looking for that left hook. But Burns at range, slightly better with them long shots, but...
Going again a little bit. Don't let him go into the shot.
Joe Gallagher, who has guided Anthony Crawler so well off for the last few years, as he comes out in his black and yellow trunks with the red boots and the red and white stripes with the blue waistband of Ricky Burns. In fight number 49, Burns, who started back in 2001. Remember when he fought Carl Johansson and picked himself up the floor 3 times to lose on points? You'd never thought he'd achieved what he has. It's been a wonderful story.
Well, Johansson was a big puncher, but he showed a lot of heart that night, he really did.
Proved his mettle, as did Anthony Crawler, coming back from that defeat to Derry Matthews, rebuilding that wonderful win over John Murray he had here, breathing fire into his career. So many ups and downs. Highly seasoned, terrific athletes doing battle.
Ricky Burns using his jab well there in round one, and he's got a nice tight defence, so when Crawler responds, a lot of the work's landing on the gloves. Don't get me wrong, he's had some success, Crawler, but Burns, with that jab and that defence, was looking good early on, but Crawler now trying to make a bit more of a statement, stepping in with his shots.
There's a good right hand to the body from Crawler a few seconds or so ago. He'll be wanting to slow Burns down. He knows the Scotsman has a chin of granite, never been stopped. So, although he was down in that first world title win early against Roman Martinez at the Kelvin Hall, he knows he's tough as old boots, but maybe the body will wear down, especially at lightweight and at 34. So Crawler will be looking for that, but Burns, pretty cool and calm.
There's been a few concerns about Burns back down at lightweight at 34, but from what I'm hearing in the gym, he's performing really well, inspiring, and the 12 rounds have been no problem. And he's virtually on the weight and training also, which is good to hear.
Crawler trying to put a few more punches together in this, the second. Burns wild there. It's going to be so nip and tuck, isn't it? Edgy, until it really catches fire.
I think it will be, yeah. Anthony Crawler landed a straight right hand to the stomach of Burns a couple of times, and that's a good tactic early on. There it goes again. And as Burns backs up, he'll happily take them on the stomach and think that's no problem. But as the fight draws on, you start to feel them. They take the wind and they make you tired. Burns working well early on to the body.
It was a right counter from Burns, but more volume from Crawler here in the second. Decent defences, the pair, as of course you would expect at this level.
Well, Crawler can't sit back at the end of Burns' long jab and be dictated to.
Phenomenal atmosphere here in Manchester as Anthony Crawler out of that blue corner, the home fighter from Manchester, family man like Ricky Burns is. Burns from Coatbridge, just outside Glasgow. And they finally meet, and it's been a domestic dust-up that everybody's been looking forward to. And finding a winner, trying to pick one, being so problematic. Good work from Crawler at the beginning of the third. Is it one apiece so far?
I think so. I've got my scorecard one apiece. Nice work there from Crawler. Right hand to the body, left up to the head. And he's targeting that body because it's almost wide open for him. You can see he's looking down. I mean, he's looking in the eyes, but then he looks to the body and he sends that right hand out. There he's going again, looking for that same shot. Ricky Burns needs to slip away to his right, not his left, and get behind that jab. Up close, I thought Crawler would take over slightly and prefer it inside, and that seems to be what's happening. It's early days yet, but Crawler comfortable with close quarters.
That's where Burns wants it, behind the jab with the right hand. Crawler in, pickpocketing him with body shots.
If Burns is going to sit back with that jab, he needs to put the right hand. He looked for it there and he went over the top of the head of Crawler. And if he's going to sit behind the jab, he needs to double it up and put the right hand there as well.
No real signs of issues after those two big fights with Jorge Linares. Crawler straight back into it. The first one was closer, the second one really outclassed pretty much the whole way through by Linares, but so brave, Crawler getting through it. But Ricky Burns had a nightmare against Julius Ndongo, but then Ndongo was all wrong for him. I felt after that one, I wondered what Ricky had left, but stylistically, it was so tough that.
Yeah, it was terrible. Ndongo, a big puncher as well, and he's brutally tough and strong, keeps coming forward. And, you know, you mentioned Crawler there, the two losses to Linares. That's no disgrace. He's losing to good quality. I mean, look at Luke Campbell last week, great fighter. He sat behind me, Olympic champion. He came very close with that knockdown as well. So Crawler lost to in really, really good company there.
It's a wonderful 9-stone-9 division. We saw a new British champion earlier. It's always been one of those great weight classes. A long-time commentator, Jim Watt, of course, reigning supreme, Ken Buchanan, so many over the years. Billy Schwer, I saw the other day, what a great lightweight he was. It's a fabulous class, isn't it?
It's a great division. It has been, though, for over the years. Crawler here stepping forward and doing slightly more work for me on the inside, looking for that right hand to the body, and Ricky Burns just falling short and missing far too often with that jab.
Big smile on his face, the Olympic golden boy, how well he did against Jorge Linares out in Los Angeles, alongside our former colleague Glenn McCrory. Great to see him here working for TalkSport just behind us tonight as we enter the fourth round. Glenn's seen so many of these close affairs through the years. We'll be checking on his card a bit later. I think you've got Crawler just edging it at the moment, but so much to fight for, so long to go.
It's really tight, it's difficult to pick these rounds. There's not much in it at all. But Burns, I feel, just needs to stick with that jab and put something on the jab. Nice counter left up there as Crawler tried to seek out the body. But Burns needs to be busier. If he's going to opt for the box and move tactics, he needs to be busy with that jab.
Left hand from Crawler. Not a massive puncher, 13 knockouts in his 31 wins, 14 knockouts in 41 victories for Ricky Burns.
Nice counter punching from Crawler there. As Burns landed the shot, Crawler responded straight away with the left hook. He was confident to stay there, soak up the shot from Burns and then reply with his own shot. Nice head movement, slipping and sliding, then straight back at his opponent.
A body shot from Crawler. There's the jab from Burns, but misses there, and Crawler straight back on him.
Burns was looking for that right hand, he loaded up with it slightly. Crawler saw it coming and then rolled under, counter punch, left up to the body, left up to the head. Textbook stuff, really, which he does so well, Crawler.
Just missing a bit, not finding his range here, Ricky Burns. And there's the body shots as well. Tries the uppercut to Crawler.
Well, out of range, Crawler slipping and sliding nasty. He's got a good tight defence. And up close, he's the one getting the shots in. It's a little sign of desperation there with Burns just chopping away with his right hand as his left forearm was on Crawler's chin. Crawler, I feel, looks comfortable and he looks a little bit more, he's enjoying himself. He looks like he's concentrating at the same time though. Really, really concentrating on what Burns is doing, looking for that counter punch. Burns needs to wake up a bit with that jab, start to double it up and move and look for the right hand counter. That's Crawler, close the gap. There's the work, double jab right hand, stepping back. That's the kind of pressure we need to see from Burns.
That's what he did in the first round, Ricky Burns, behind that jab, doubling up. Climbed up through the weights, but he has come back down again at 34. Looks for the uppercut, and Crawler says, okay, you do that, I'll give you one back.
He does, he answers straight back.
You just know these two are going to be mates a long time from now. The gladiatorial spirit. I think they're really pleased they're fighting each other.
I think they are, and it makes sense. It's such a great fight. Both fighters at almost a very similar point of their career. I mean, Burns a bit older, so you know it's more of a must-win fight for Burns.
The half step back from Anthony Crawler and making Ricky Burns miss with the jabs. He's got it to a rhythm quickly, hasn't he, Crawler?
Well, that's the footwork there from Crawler. I mean, it's stuff that you work on in the gym every day, and that little step back helps you out so much as your opponent's moving forward. If the opponent makes a mistake, leaves his gloves low off, leans over, reaches over his feet, and he's losing balance, that counter right hand or right hand left hook can go in. Textbook stuff from Crawler, but he's doing it so well. And, you know, he's been here before in big fights. He knows these fights go 12 rounds, got the engine. At the minute, he's doing very well, Crawler.
Sends out bell 5.
A quarter of the way through this lightweight battle, and it's edgy stuff. Rounds have been close. Did Burns win the opener? Crawler come back with one. Third was a tight one, was the fourth Crawler's. It's a really difficult one already to separate, as we thought. Look at the odds before. I think the boys were saying, you ask, you know, five people, 2-2, and maybe one would go for the draw. It's always had that look of a close fight.
Yes, yeah, it's one of them kind of fights. I mean, I've always thought since the fight was made that Crawler would maybe be the victor on points, just because he's got that... the years on his side. He's 30 years old and he's more comfortable at this weight, but doesn't really mean a great deal.
And he's at home in Manchester, but then Ricky Burns has travelled around the world and he's performed on a number of stages.
Ricky Burns won't let it bother him that he's in Manchester, but it certainly will help Crawler, because he can hear and feel the crowd as they cheer his work, and it does help, in my opinion, it helps.
Good body shots from Crawler. Burns missing, just chipping away there. Got big punches from Crawler. Back comes Burns, but walks into a left hand. Is the edge in speed and freshness just with Crawler? Burns it's a bit ragged.
It's the counter punching from Crawler, and when Burns does get ragged, which he does, Crawler's able to capitalise on that and land them counter punches. I mean, Burns having a go now, doing more work, trying to lean on Crawler and pushing back to them ropes, because he knows he'll feel that these rounds are maybe slipping away from him, so he needs to try and make some kind of mark.
Body shot from Crawler, really beginning to warm up. You feel them going into a second gear now, the two fighters, as they swap uppercuts and some intense action, and Crawler just comes off better.
You just feel that up close, Crawler is going to come off better. He's slightly shorter levers, shorter on the arms, and he lands their body and headshot counters so well. They work on that a lot with Joe Gallagher in that gym. The up close work, we're sitting here nicely. He's got his back against the ropes. He's having good success.
Good combination from Crawler and a good tight defense as well when Burns came back.
Yeah, nice response from Burns, but he had the last of the argument, Crawler, in that little exchange. And he's first to start the argument here. He's really pressing the work on here, Crawler. Burns is struggling to stay with him because he needs to just work that little bit more. There's nothing in it. It's fine margins, as it is with all sports at top level. But Crawler, he's just in front here with his work rate and his accuracy.
They're really swapping body shots this the round where Anthony Crawler's dream came true. Stopping Darnis Perez with one beautiful hook. And the Manchester Arena erupted that like back comes Burns digging his own in. Now it's really started this fight.
See Crawler here coming inside of a nice tight guard, slipping that right hook response counter from Burns, and he's doing it all so often. Sneaks in nice, and he's landing a jab there out of range and looking straight away for that right hook, and that shot slips right into the ribcage of Burns, and that he would have felt that round, that body shot, and that will take it out of him as these rounds go on. Good work from Crawler. Don't get me wrong, Burns is one in this fight. He uses his jab. He's okay with the jab. He needs to be more effective with that jab. He needs to work a bit more. But Crawler just seems to be a little bit more relaxed and having more success when he throws his punches. And he'll grow and grow from that unless Ricky Burns can do something to put a dent in him.
Round six.
The sixth round, the 257th for Anthony Crawler, the 379th for Ricky Burns. Former world champions. Luke Campbell watching on. Are there still great nights ahead for this pairing? Who's going to come out on top? Will we have a close decision, even a draw? Will they do it again? I'll tell you what they are doing. They're meeting in the middle. It's phone booth stuff now. And look at that respect there. There's no nastiness.
Real good sportsmanship there. I don't always like to see that during the fight. I wasn't one for touching gloves before and after rounds. And the last round to get the respect, but Burns hitting Crawler there low and stopping. And it is nice to see.
You mean you didn't do that with George Groves?
Burns having a go now, landing a bit more shots, but Crawler's always there with the answer, looking for the counter punch, which he does so well.
Still sticking to the double jab and the right hand, Ricky Burns. That's given him so much success in those divisions.
He's opting for a tight defense here, Burns. He's sitting back as Crawler works. Burns is nicely tightly tucked up, trying a bit of head movement there, but what he needs to do when he's taking shots on the gloves and arms is answer straight back. He needs to punch like now, but Crawler's away from him, but that's going to be bad news for Burns. I mean, good head movement from Crawler on his back foot here.
Yep, getting out of the way of punches well there, the Manchester man.
If Burns is going to sit in front of Crawler and opt for this tactic to maybe try and tire him down and stretch a little bit, he needs to respond with counter punches or these rounds will go away from him. Crawler's very effective up close. He's hooking nicely to the body and he's landing the odd jab, which almost puts him real in front with the judges. When the judges are looking for shots, they're looking for body and head shots that are landing, but then whoever's dictating behind that jab looks like they're dominating.
Good jab to the body from Crawler, and it was Burns dominating with the jab earlier. Deep into the sixth round. Crawler just the nip and tuck style, outspeeding him. Good defense as well.
Good defense and a slightly better work rate. There's not much in it, but the work rate just does seem to be slightly higher from Crawler. It's his punches that catch the eye, I think.
Burns tries a body shot, Crawler back. They momentarily hold, and Terry O'Connor has his first job to do, really. There's the body shots and one to the head again for Crawler. Back comes Burns at the bell, but the speed of Crawler there.
Anthony Crawler there marching forward. Burns opting for the tight peekaboo style defence where he tucked up tightly behind a vertical forearms, but it's no good if you're not responding back because the judges like to see that work.
Second half of this lightweight tussle in front of a very big crowd here at the Manchester Arena. And you've got Anthony Crawler in a commanding lead. There's differences of opinion, as always there are at ringside, but most people around us have got Crawler winning this.
Well, it's a really close fight. I mean, really, really close rounds, and people think, well, why is it so one-sided? Well, it's simply because Crawler's winning the rounds. He might not be winning them by much, but he's winning them, in my opinion. So that's how I've scored it.
Steve Gray, Victor Lochan, and Michael Alexander, who's just in front of us. Well, the three very experienced, good judges at ringside. Better from Burns there.
Nice right hand. That's the right hand that he needs to get behind after the jab lands. Jab right hand, and then get back behind that tight defence. But when he's got the tight defence, he needs to move his legs and get back to the centre of the ring. And then again, counter punch. Crawler so effective up close. He picks the holes nicely.
Burns body shot, side to side, digging them in. Crawler trying to come back with an uppercut, but it's an increase in tempo, this, from Ricky Burns. Maybe the corner, Tony Sims and the boys feel that he needs to up the work rate, because Crawler's, he's very busy, isn't he? This is better from Burns.
Crawler is busy. You can tell Burns now is having to go, he's working harder.
Grueling already, and we're only in the seventh.
Crawler just looks slightly more comfortable up close. When they come head to head, lock horns and work away to the body and head, Crawler just seems a bit more comfortable. Don't get me wrong, Burns having his fair share of success here in close.
I think he might have felt that was a little bit low, but the smile was okay inside the last minute of the seventh. Again, they've been swapping body shots, both having their successes, but it's a drive from Burns here. And Crawler matches him now. All about the body tonight, isn't it?
Well, yeah, it's difficult to land on the headshots with that tight guard and the head movement, so work away at the body. The body was slow.
Oh, lovely uppercut from Ricky Burns. Sweet shot there from the Scotsman.
Nice uppercut, and it's shots like that, eye-catching shots, that can be the difference between winning and losing the round when it's close.
Much better round this from Ricky Burns. He's found something.
Well, he's been busier, and he's landed a nice uppercut there.
Good defence too. Nice hooks. You can never write Burns off. Time and time again, he comes back and proves us wrong. Blood from the nose of Crawler. And Ricky Burns will be happy about this session. Let's get it straight over to Andy with Jamie Moore.
Jamie, plenty to like about this fight so far, particularly Anthony Crawler's body shots. How are you seeing the fight, and what have you made of his body work on the inside?
I thought they both worked the body really well. I think Anthony's just been one step ahead work rate wise. I've scored the fight 5-2 so far. I gave Ricky Burns that round just. That nice uppercut at the end just bloodied Anthony Crawler's nose just towards the end of the round. But I think body shots wise, Anthony Crawler's landing sort of 2-1 to Ricky Burns's, and that's got to have an effect. And although it is, all the rounds are close, I just think that Anthony Crawler's finishing the rounds a little sharper and then finishing the round sharper. In the middle parts, Ricky Burns is having good success, but for me, Anthony Crawler's just doing the better work.
Ricky Burns needed that uppercut as well, didn't he, at the end of the round?
He certainly did, and it's at this point of the fight when, you know, both guards are going to start getting tired, and if Anthony Crawler's nose starts bleeding, that could cause him problems.
Thanks, Jamie.
Jamie has Crawler by 3, Matthew Macklin just behind us, Crawler by 1, Dave Colwell, Crawler by 3, Glenn McCrory right behind us has it level. So none of them have got Burns in front, but he did have a good round there.
Well, and it was just that one shot, that uppercut. Don't get me wrong, he was busy and he was matching Crawler for the work rate, but then he landed that eye-catching uppercut that seemed to have drew blood from the nose of Anthony Crawler. He's looking for that uppercut again, Burns. He needs to land a couple of catching shots to stamp his authority in this fight.
He's more hardened at world level, Ricky Burns. Some of those defences weren't the best over the years, but he has been in with the likes of Terence Crawford and Ray Beltran and Omar Figueroa. Good, good fighters. Crawler, yes, Jorge Linares. Darlis Perez, not quite the same list, though.
Yeah, Barroso, I mean, he's shared the room with good fighters and great fighters. But Ricky Burns done it for longer and done it more often. So as this fight draws on now, Ricky Burns will know if he needs to work more, and he does. And he has started to do that now, backing up Crawler here.
Burns had that fabulous four-round win over Kevin Mitchell, which was a real eye-catcher 5 years ago. Mitchell felt Burns would come through this. Crowd really rallying behind Crawler. Their pockets of Scottish support too.
Under pressure there, Crawler on the ropes, turning his man Burns and landing some nice shots in response. Burns working really well and really hard in this round, as he did in the last round.
We talk about the British title bringing something out of you. Obviously, if you're fighting for a world crown, there's no belt on the line here. It doesn't matter one little bit.
It's what's at stake, though, after this. The prize is in the next fight, so this is a must-win fight for both men.
But I think they also want to give entertainment and value to all the fans that have followed them for so many years.
I think you're right, and they're both doing that. Ricky Burns stepped up, but Crawler not wanting to take a step back. Getting a bit cheeky with that head as well as he comes forward.
Still trying the turbo work rate, Anthony Crawler, but a marking under the left eye. And Burns just trying to push him back onto the ropes. Dip a right hook over the top. It is really, really tough stuff now.
We're really working hard there, Burns. Backing Crawler up to the ropes, taking shots in counter from Crawler. But looking like the busier man there, looking like he's having success and working away.
Marking under Burns' left eye as well as he throws the jab out. And the Anthony Crawler sound rings around the Manchester Arena. Good work from Burns on the counter, but back comes Crawler.
Burns marching forward here, working hard. Burns, I feel that he really has to work hard to get any kind of success and make a dent on this. Where Crawler, although he's marking up around the face, he seems to be more at ease up close, working the body and head more. Burns worked really hard in that round, and I still had to get that round level.
Very, very tight round, and some of them have been. Crawler's had the fluency, hasn't he? The rhythm, the work rate, the body shots, but he's digging in, Ricky Burns, as we know. He will. He's a 12-round fighter. So many have been when he beat Michele Di Rocco. That was a surprising stoppage after eight to become a three-weight champion. Back to the full distance against Kirill Relic, which was very tight.
Well, this is the last third of the fight, and this is, as we say, the championship round. And Ricky Burns knows that. He's been here time and time again. So he knows he needs to build on the work weight from that last round. Had you got a nice counter left hook there by Burns, he landed nice on the chin of Crawler. He's to try and keep it back. If you notice, Crawler's not kind of marching forward as heavy here, just sitting back a bit, so he'll be feeling the pace, going a bit flat-footed. Anthony Crawler breathing in the air. Don't get me wrong, Burns will be feeling the pace, but if Crawler slows down, Burns will start to grow in confidence.
The sweat stained black and yellow with that bumblebee on the side for Anthony Million Dollar Crawler. The almost American colours of Ricky Burns, but he's a proud Scotsman. Done so much for Scottish boxing over the last 10 years or so. Alex Morrison here tonight, who's long been with him. But he's gone down to Tony Sinz's gym in Essex, and he's redefined himself over the last two or three years. Anthony Crawler sticking with Joe Gallagher despite the two defeats. Scott Quigg left. He thought maybe he might follow, but he stayed loyal.
Well, if it works for him and he knows it's working for him, why would he leave? He shouldn't leave. I don't always like to see fighters move, but they feel that's what's right for them.
then do it, because if they're not happy where they are, they're not going to get the best out of the performance. Crawler sticking with Joe Gallagher, and it seems to be the right move because he is performing, he's looking good. This is a close fight. Burns is putting him on his back foot now. But Crawler in front at this stage.
Yep, you didn't move after your two losses through your long, proud career. That's the singing reverberates around the Manchester Arena, trying to pick Anthony Crawler up in the last quarter of this. Burns tries a slashing left hook and a big right hand. Both still showing they've got plenty to offer at this level.
Crawler definitely slowed down slightly this round. Nose bleeding quite heavily, that blood will be trickling down the back of the throat and hampering his breathing.
Good jab from Ricky Burns, right on that nose. And there's the blood, and a nice right counter as well from Burns.
And he's looking war-battled here, Crawler. He's taking shots, he's bleeding quite heavily. Burns will see that and he'll feel that. And if you can just press home towards the end of this round, for me, he'll seal this one. Good defence by Burns. He needs to let them shots go, needs to throw the punches.
Just holds on there, Crawler, momentarily. Is that pace getting to him? Will the nose become a problem over the last few rounds? Weary soldiers as they return to their stools. Unsurprising after this frenetic pace.
Well, Crawler trying much of the same, bit of a low blow there going in from Burns. Nothing intentional, I'm sure. Ricky Burns got a good defence, so it's how you see these shots that Crawler's landed. Are you classing them as arm punches? Are they scoring shots or not? And Burns finding a home with that jab and working up close. Still really, really tight these rounds. But for me, with Crawler taking the foot off the glass slightly and dropping the pace, and Burns realising he's in the championship round.
Another wonderful domestic clash. Close in these rounds. Honestly fought between the pair of them, Ricky Burns and Anthony Crawler. You've got Jorge Linares, Mikey Garcia, Terry Flanagan from this very city, Robert Easter, Luke Campbell just behind us. A magical division worldwide.
Big fruits await the winner of this, certainly. There's big fights for them on the global scale, there really is. Going to be another world title shot. I mean, it'll be a hard one against any of them names you pulled out there.
I was about to ask, do you think either of them can become a world champion again on what you've seen?
Well, I think it would be a matter of if they can get the shot, if they're going to take it as their last fight and leave it all in there, then why not? Why can't they have one last hurrah?
Already these two could meet again. Chuck Luke Campbell into the mix as well, Terry Flanagan. There's some great fights to be made in the next year or two, because they're proving they've got mileage still, these two.
Oh, definitely. And Ricky Burns, I like what he's doing with his gloves and his arms. He's got good defence. If the judges don't see punches landing, they won't score shots. Anthony Crawler, for sure, the busier fighter. Burns needs to capitalise on the last couple of rounds. I mean, especially the last round, where I think he just nicked. He needs to capitalise on that and get busy, get working, but, you know, at this stage of the fight, both feeling the pace.
Big burst from Anthony Crawler. How many got through? How many were on the arms and gloves of Ricky Burns?
We don't always see them punches get through to the scoring target, but if there's only one man working, usually there's only one man who can score. Good response from Burns here, nice work body in the head.
He certainly had a better patch, hasn't he, Burns? In three or four of these last rounds.
Oh, definitely. He's picking some nice counter punches. He's boxing better. And he's got a good defence. And coupled with that, Crawler's pace has dropped ever so slightly.
Right to the body from Crawler. Misses with the uppercut.
Well into the last minute here, and the round is up for grabs.
As a few have been at this stage of them. both so experienced at catching the eyes of the judges late on. Burns with a spring to his step. Body shot too. Has he just done a little bit more? Tough to judge this.
When you see one fighter coming forward and landing shots and being busy like Crawler was early on, as soon as they take the foot off the gas, it's easy to go against him. But is it right to do that? It's very subjective scoring. Burns having more success, but Crawler backing him up and having his own successes. Another very, very close round.
Another opinion. Everyone in boxing's here. Dave Caldwell.
General consensus at ringside is that the rounds are close, but the Crawler's ahead. Have you got that the same? Do you agree with that?
Yeah. Do you know what? It's tough to score because both fighters are active. I just think that Crawler's starting the attack with the body shots, gets up with a couple of shots, but then he answers. Whenever Ricky answers him, he answers back and he finishes it. So I'm just getting him. I've got him about four rounds up. But it's not telling the story of the fight. Every round's so hard.
Does either man hit hard enough to force the stoppage?
No, I don't think so. There's some good body shots going in. And Ricky, I think Crawler's felt a few little left hooks that Ricky's been landing, but I don't think that there's going to be a stoppage. I think he's going to get points, but I think that Ricky's really got up the work rate. It's a contact to flick out the jab and not do enough work.
Thanks, Dave.
Just looking back at Johnny Nelson, he's got Crawler miles in front. Luke Campbell has got it about level. It's one of those. It's so subjective.
It is one of them. It's very, very close. When you see Burns throw some work and do some nice shots landed, you just tend to sway with him, but you can't forget the work of Anthony Crawler because it is good body and head. Burns sitting down on his shots now, making noise as he throws the shots.
You've got Crawler one up. Dave Caldwell, I think he said four up. Matt Macken's got Crawler up, but it's all about the three judges. 6 minutes left. Crawler, good uppercuts there, body shots as well.
Warming up there, both fighters landing some good shots, body in the head. Nice attacks from Burns, nice response from Crawler, then comes back Burns. I mean, this is neck and neck, very level shooting at this stage. Both fighters are feeling the pace, but both know how much they need to do to work to win the round. The corner men, very experienced in both corners, will be telling them, you have to work.
Drenched with sweat. The exertion physically has been excellent. Right hand from Burns. Again, Crawler comes back with combinations. It's almost like the single shots of Burns, the bursts of Crawler.
Well, the four-punch combination there from Burns. Well, I know he throws a lot of singles, but he threw a left-right, left-hook, straight right hand, then he defended, then answered back. But then Crawler with four body shots, finishing on the head. This is tight, this is close.
Leaning on him there, Crawler. Good shot there. That freshness, the speed he showed, certainly. But a lot of patches of the fight. I think it's very split online as well, Carl.
It is very good work from both men in this ring here. Burns just trying to keep it long, but Crawler slipping and sliding, getting in close. But good defense from Burns. It's just how you see this fight going, it's how you're judging it and what you're seeing landing. I mean, them kind of body shots there from Crawler are good.
Yeah, good body shots from Crawler. I think he's had more rhythm through the fight. I think he's put his punches together better, but there have been bursts of Burns.
He comes back nicely, Burns. He's answering back. There's a left hook, straight right, landed clean. Crawler took a step back there and smiled. That's an acknowledgement of a good shot landed.
It's one of these fights that I don't think anyone's going to score exactly the same. Some are going to give Crawler some of the rounds, some Burns, but maybe different ones. But look at this from the power of them. And they open up in the last 25 seconds of the 11th. The crowd rallying. Two great professionals, former world champions, who want another shot. Good jab from Burns, but is it enough?
What did I say to you 4 or 5 rounds ago? When he's wanting to throw, just move your feet, all right? Ricky's haven't got no legs, and he's just throwing shots, arm shots. You're not moving, so they're hitting you. And you can't risk getting caught. You can't risk getting caught with silly right hands on the back of the head.
I think Anthony Crawler is winning this fight by whatever margin, 1, 2, 3, 4. I think it's going to be tough to give it to Ricky Burns unless he does something dramatic in the last round. And I think that's the feeling of ringside, whatever the margins. But Anthony Crawler's done that bit more pretty much all the way through, however tight some of the rounds have been.
Yeah, I totally agree with that, Adam. It'd be hard to disagree with that, but Burns has had his moments of success and he's got that tight defence. So it's what the judges like, simple as that.
Probably Crawler by two or three, he's by one on your card. Who knows how the judges have got it? Michael Alexander, Victor Loughlin and Steve Gray. What a this finish, no knockdowns. Neither fighter really hurt. We expected 12 hard rounds, and that's what we've got. How good's it been? As good as you thought it would be?
Well, it looks good sitting here from ringside. We only see one side. The viewers at home see him a couple of different angles. They see it from a couple of different angles, and I always see more. He walks into a big right hand there. Burns did, and seemed to hold on after that. It was a nice shot from Crawler. But no, I think this fight, it's been entertaining, it's been close, it's been nipped up, and it's been action-packed.
Crawler's just put his punches together a bit more effectively. It's bringing his step when it's needed. Maybe it is that, the age gap, the 30 to 34, the extra freshness of Crawler, and maybe that he's come off the Linares fights a bit better than Burns has off in Dongo.
Well, early on in the fight, Crawler was landing them body shots and putting more work together, and Burns was having to sit there behind that guard thinking he was getting away with it, but he wasn't. He was getting caught with shots, eye-catching shots to the body, and that's where it slipped away from him, but he's answering back nicely here.
Yeah, nice combination by Ricky Burns. Do you think both fighters will feel they've done enough?
Well, there's an argument, isn't there, for both fighters to think they've done enough. I mean, I'm sure the cornerman will be telling them, you're in this, it's all on this last round. And they're both working like they need to win this last round. But I think Crawler will feel he's in front.
They know the sport so well, they're both saying they'd love to watch this actually happen, but they're in it. And they've been right in it for the word go. Nice shot from Ricky Burns. And again, blood from the nose of Anthony Crawler.
Ricky Burns landed some nice single right hands in this round, counter right hands. Crawler's coming forward, just stumbled there, Crawler getting behind Crawler, but Burns landing that right hand.
Yeah, good finishes from Ricky Burns. As he tightened it up again. Fascinating to see how the judges have got it as we approach the last 30 seconds of what's been, as expected, a hard-fought and grueling affair. We'd like to see more, wouldn't we?
We would, yeah. It's been about the 15-round age, because that's what we need here. We need another three rounds to separate the men from the boys. They're both men in there tonight. They've both left it all in there. But we want more, don't we?
I think we do. Will we see it again? Possibly. Will Crawler get it? Burns with a good finish. Has the Manchester man done that bit more? There's the embrace. They both raised their hands aloft. And they both gave a titanic effort from start to finish. It was a pleasure to enjoy the 36 minutes of entertaining ring action. They did their bit. What will the judges see, Carl?
Well, I think they'll see what we saw. A very, very close fight, hard fought by both men. This is a tight, tight decision. Could you argue with a draw? I think if Ricky Burns gets a draw, he'll probably be happy with that. He's happy here, parading around the ring with his arms in his head. I think Crawler's done enough by one or two rounds on my card. I think he's just nicked it from the early rounds, and he was more than in the fight late on, don't get me wrong. But Ricky Burns really did play his part, fought really well, fought out of his skin, and did very, very well in the end, landing some nice long jabs and counter right hands.
Jamie Moore's got it a draw. Matthew Macklin, Crawler by two. Glenn McCrory behind us, Crawler by two. I know Dave Colwell had Crawler in a big lead, so did Johnny Nelson. No one's got it to Burns at ringside. I think that's about right, your card, in whatever way you get to it.
And that's what usually happens with scoring. When the rounds are tight, you tend to not try and shear them out, but it tends to balance itself out. And people moan at a 10-10 round. If a round's even and you can't pick a winner of that round's even. Unfortunately, for the viewers that don't like a 10-10 round, that is what it is. It means I cannot separate or pick a winner. This fight is close. I feel that Crawler has just done enough.
Me too. I think Crawler by a couple like you, but by a totally different route. Well done to the pair of them. Michael Buffer's standing by. Let's hear it.
Here in Manchester, after 12 rounds, Burns, Crawler, let's give them a hand. We go to the scorecards. Victor Laughlin has it 116-113. Steve Gray, 117-112. Michael Alexander, 116-114. All three cards to the winner by unanimous decision. The Fighting Pride of Manchester, Anthony Million Dollar
Crawler. Anthony Crawler wins the battle of the so-called veterans. They've still got a bit to offer, these two, by one, by two, and by five. So different scorecards, but I think that is the right winner of what was a fascinating fight to watch. Well, they got there, didn't they, the judges, and they were all to Crawler. As we said at ringside, you couldn't find a winner for Burns. Level, closer some, but no one had Ricky Burns winning it, although I think he thought he was going to. Let's get to Andy.
Two of the nicest guys in boxing, 12 toe-to-toe rounds, and you're standing arm-in-arm now. Anthony, come to you first. To win that fight in this arena must mean something really special to you.
Yeah, Ray. So special, Manchester, I love you.
Talk us through the fight. The general consensus was it was close. Were you sure that you had done enough?
Yeah, I thought I'd definitely done enough, but, man, I knew how this guy's engine was, and he just kept coming, and people was on about me thinking, oh, would he tire because he's come down to lightweight? I knew he wouldn't, and he gave me a very, very tough fight, but I thought that my quality of shots won it.
Would you like to come back here and have another shot at a world title?
Of course I would. Listen, of course I would. This is what I owe these people. I owe them another world title. The way they turn out and get behind me, it's nothing but love. Listen, down the line, we've got no problem in going Glasgow, have we, for the rematch at some point? We'll give Ricky another shot at some point. But for now, yeah, we'll look at what's next in the pipeline.
Ricky, he said he would do it again. Would you want to do it again?
Oh, 100%. Do you know? Although it was close, right, I thought I'd done enough damage out there. I'd say I was landing the cleaner shots. I'm a wee bit gutted, man, but, Joe, I would love if Anthony's up for it. If Eddie can make it happen, let's do it.
You've been written off before countless times. Can you come again?
Oh, Joe, in my eyes, honestly, I thought I just edged that, man. Sorry, Anthony, but that's what I think, man.
Nice, lad. Listen, in a hard fight, you're going to feel that. I thought it was quality over quantity. But I understand when Ricky pushes himself out, that's what I thought, but I thought I deserved the win tonight.
Respect to both of you.